it's been revealed Queensland councils are spending tens of thousands of dollars on welcome to country ceremonies.
Yeah, Brisbane ratepayers have shelled out $135,000 for the insult of being welcomed to their own country in the last 2 years alone.
Reconciliation Australia have defended the expenditure, saying taking the time to acknowledge country or including a welcome to country at an event reminds us that every day we live, work and dream on Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander lands. You know, we're in the middle of a cost of living crisis, and for councils to be spending hundreds of thousands of dollars on ceremonies that most people don't want, that most people would say they voted against last November at the referendum, that most people certainly don't want to be paying for, and for Reconciliation Australia to say that we need to be reminded on a regular basis that we live and work on somebody else's land, I'm just not sure how that matches with the idea of reconciliation. How do you bring people together by repeatedly reminding them that they're different and to add salt to the wound, making one group pay the other group for the privilege of being reminded of that? Now, the Brisbane City Council did defend the expenditure, saying, oh, it's not just a welcome to country, there's tribal dancing, there's fire lighting, there's a smoking ceremony, which I thought was interesting since a smoking ceremony is to ward off evil spirits. If you ask most Australians, do they want to have to foot the bill for Aboriginal spirituality, they would say not in a million years, and yet we're being forced to pay for this stuff.
Yeah, well, I like that quote you just read out. It reminds us every day we live, work and dream on Aboriginal lands. Well, I dream of the day that I don't have to go to an event and be subjected to another welcome to country, which goes for half hour because, you know, you get a preamble, then you get the welcome to country, then you get more, you know, ramble off the back of that. But councils are absolutely in the firing line. I blame councils, to be honest, for a lot of this nonsense that goes on, because when you think about it, the roads, rates, rubbish, forget it. That's out the window, long gone. Yeah. The councils are the ones, James, who decided on behalf of ratepayers that they would change the day to celebrate Australia Day. They would change the day that citizenship ceremonies are held. They seem to be making a lot of decisions that affect our lives, but not necessarily the ones that are going to improve our lives. And if we don't start pushing back against this, we're going to continuously be overrun by these organisations and councils who want to shove this nonsense down our throats constantly, and we're sick to death of it, James.
Yeah,
it's
absolutely
just ridiculous. And the other issue here is the treaty negotiations between the Victorian state government and Indigenous groups. They're going to begin later this month, despite, as we just said, no one voted for a treaty.
State Premier Jacinta Allen has left open the possibility that private land could be compulsorily acquired and given to Indigenous groups. And there's also the suggestion that a public holiday could be created to celebrate Indigenous culture. What's amazing about this is no one voted for treaties in Victoria. The negotiations are happening behind closed doors, and the legislation was enacted in such a way, and I should point out, with the support of the Victorian Liberal Party at the time, such that whatever treaty is arranged between the Crown and Indigenous groups, it doesn't need to go to the public for approval.
Well, James, look what's happening here in New South Wales, the Blaney Mine, where Tanya Plibersek relied on the voice of 18 people from a random Aboriginal group, as opposed to those who actually make these sorts of Aboriginal land decisions. This is what treaty does, and we don't even have treaties yet. So if you want to see more rainbow serpents popping up here and there, things in waters, you can't dig a hole here, that is the pathway of treaty that we're heading down.
You know, the first thing David Crisafulli did within the first week and a bit of becoming Premier of Queensland, he got rid of truth-telling and treaty, which the Labor government had enacted. They've done the same in the Northern Territory, that the Liberal Party in Victoria originally supported a treaty is one of the reasons why they're doing so badly. If they want to be in power, they should take a leaf out of
I just want to make one more. The Indigenous groups also said that they're angered by the failed voice for referendum and are out for blood. Still not accepting the result, the majority
of Australians. What happened to reconciliation?
Correct.
We are one.
What happened to actually trying to make better outcomes for Aboriginal people, which is what we want.
Yes, exactly. Absolutely.